Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, and yeah, so welcome back to Space Engineers. I've been pretty busy so far. I'll show you what I've been up to, but I'll also tell you about my frustration with this game. You'll see most of the base isn't finished. You'll see tunnels like this, but yeah, if you walk upstairs, you'll see the lights that come on. Let's run back down. As we walk up, it should all switch on. Nicely done there. We've got a control center here, lots of computers. You can imagine people here being busy and whatnot. A couple of cargo containers that I need to move. There's an area down here that still needs to be finished. Still got the window here, but I don't want to show you what I've been working on just yet. This all needs to be welded up. But part of this game, when you set up a weld, this is what I run the problem with. You pretty much set up everything up. So you set how easy the planet's going to be on with iron and all that, basically. And then you set up also the weld once you leave the planet. Once you get in your spaceship, you leave the planet, you set it up and you say how many asteroids are out there floating. Now, if you didn't set this up, once you leave the planet, there will be no asteroids out in space, you know, floating around, basically. So you will have no chance of getting any ore, any supplies, and be able to build anything out in space if you didn't set it up. And the only way to get around it is by starting a new world. Which would mean, if I started a new world, I would lose this whole base that I've spent hours building. Absolutely hours. There is a way around it. What you can do is, once you get into space with your spaceship, create a new world and then copy your spaceship into the new world. But I would still lose the base. You can copy the base into the new world. If it's a base that sits on top of the land, it's fine. But because this is dug into the side of a mountain, once it's pasted into the ground, I'd have to run around with a drill, drilling, you know, the shape of the base out, basically, inside and out. Which I don't really want to do. But the good news is that I managed to get out into space and find asteroids. However, the recording I had on that has completely mucked up. I don't know what's happening. There's no audio to it. There's video and there's my mic, but there's no audio to it, which is a pain, because it was a really good episode before I showed this. Basically, we went into space. I didn't take enough ice with me to get any more hydrogen, so we just landed on the planet, and it made a really intense video. But anyway, let's run around to the thing that I've built. This is a pipe, obviously. This is the cargo hangar. My idea here was to have computer screens here and all here and all down here, but my time went on to making a ship rather than finishing up this base. We got cargo containers here for all the ore. I'll show the system in a minute. Currently, Olga is full up with ice, so we'll dump that off in a second. But yeah, I was hoping to put also a lift in the corner here, using pistons. So you can, you know, use a lift to get up to this section if needed. But, you know, everything went on hold to build the spaceship, which you should see soon. Hope you like it. It's some angles it's beautiful, some angles it's ugly. Just like my normal builds. Go to cargo hangar first, and then we'll go downstairs. So all this, I'd hope to block up, make walls and everything, but it didn't work, basically. So let's run into the cargo hangar. No lights, no nothing. This is the cargo hangar. I didn't get around to putting a light switch on, but I did put switches on. There we go. I love the spotlight shining on Olga. It's pretty cool effect, I thought. It would be good to set up sensors so each ship you get near in the landing zone, the spotlight comes on. But maybe I'll get around to that in the future. These are all containers. Olga drops stuff off. there's pipework underneath that forces ore into these containers. I haven't managed to be able to do it in an even distribute the ore either to each container. Here we are. You didn't see the episode either with the welder. I've named her Mary because she is bloody reliable. She hasn't even let me down. Oh, my phone's going off. I'll answer that in a second. Yeah, but again, she still texts me. It's pretty funny. I told her not to to text me because I'm doing a lap time in the Co-Landers League, and yeah, now she's like, you done your league? She laughs at me for that. Anyway, yeah, all the audio is mucked up, so you lost all the build of it and everything, which is a pain. Hold on, what am I going to do? I need to text her. I can't just let her hang, because she still texts me, as you can hear. Right, so yeah, I named her Mary because I said she is damn reliable. I mean, I've even switched out the welders at one stage and put grinders on them, and was grinding down the old lander base we had down there, which again is another video you won't be able to see because the audio isn't working. She's called Mary because I don't know of a single Mary that is not reliable. We got old Betsy down here just cruising, power's off. I refuse to dismantle her. I mean, she's pretty much started off this whole base. She was a lugging cargo from the lander up into this mountain. She barely take it, but she got up here. And of course, you know Olga. Olga's changed a little bit. If you remember before, she had a... Oh, let's get back up. She had a pipe and a connector coming out the cockpit, straight up. Looked a bit odd. But Rebel Cowboy gave me a bit of advice in one of the comments. He said under my ejectors, I should put collectors at my base. So then all I need to do is land and eject all the minerals, all the ores that I've collected, dump it in. And what happens is, so we get this right, so we get the right pipe. If I show it in, the solder block connected to the bottom of the connectors, the collectors, and it runs down this pipe here on the right and into the cargo containers. Now, I do have a solder block. Which one is it? I think it's around here. I have a solder block pushing ore into this one. I was hoping it's going to evenly distribute it to all the cargo containers, but it doesn't. So I think what I'm going to have to do is loop around a square of conveyors around and add in solder blocks on each corner. And the pipe on the right is the pipe you saw. I'm stuck at the moment. Wait there. Just turn the lights on. Yeah, the pipe on the right is the pipe you saw going up when we came down the stairs through the window. It was quite a cool little effect. Let me show you this in action. Let's go to one of my sorters and change the blacklist. Whitelist to blacklist. And now it's going to start dumping everything out. We actually dropped a little bit. Yeah, so there you go, in the sorter. Runs along that pipe. You should see it in this one. Oh, maybe not that one. Thought it would have been that one. Here we go. Oh, it's not moving because I don't have this solder block set up to move ice. So let's do that now. Oh, it is. Right, so maybe it just moves it in a minute. Who knows? I'm not sure what is going on. It does move iron. So, yeah, anyway. It's in the right area. So I no longer have the connector up. She just does her thing, and once she's finished, I come down and switch her off. Which is all good. Really? The other button I didn't show you. It's the cargo door. I don't want to get too close at the moment, because when they open, they are loud. I mean, mean, I think there's 8 of them, 16 of them all together.
And we've got...
Oh, we don't want to get too close to that window, so I won't count just yet, but... Yeah, let's look here. Oh, no. We've got some catwalk there, and that may take us down to the main entrance. Anyway, let's leave Olga to do a thing. Close these. We can switch off all the lights here. Close the door. It'd be good to have sensors on these as you walk in, the lights turn on. Here I set up a little pillars. You see the doors closed there. The idea is to have these scattered around the base. So if you thought like a bit of a role-playing scenario, if anyone attacked the base, you could push this and it would bring down, you know, cargo hangers or blast walls over the windows, over the doors, and seal you in. But once I found out I may have mucked up my weld, I sort of gave up and started working the ship. If we walk down here, we've got a sensor light that'll pop on. Lights turn on. Still only running on one large reactor. Seems to be enough power, so it's a bit of a waste of space. Medical bay in there. This is where we need to be careful here. This door is going to automatically open. I haven't sealed this off just yet. Some of the pipe work. Yeah, let's sort it off now. Alright, so this is going to open. I'm going to walk in backwards because I don't want to show you the ship. And it's going to close. You remember before I used to have refineries and assemblers either side, but now these are cargo containers for ingots, and these are cargo containers for components. So let's walk downstairs backwards so I don't show you. And here we have assemblers, way too many assemblers at the moment. Don't use them all, but it's good to be able to blast through things. I mean, currently we go through so much ore at the moment, especially when it's coming to building that ship. Don't have lights here, so I need to work on that. Let's show you the ship. Now, she's not light, but somehow that pipe is able to hold her. Yeah, so some angles I quite like it, some angles I don't. Show the catwalk up here actually. I'll just show you it all. There's the cargo hangar. So from the back, I think it looks pretty cool. I do think the size of the ship should have been longer. I don't know if it's the correct shape, but as I said, there's a bit of a rush job because I wanted to get out there and see if I could find any asteroids. So yeah, this is here. I thought I painted the bottom bit, but I guess I didn't. So we've got two large hydro thrusters, a large atmospheric thruster, and three more large and a load of atmospheric thrusters scattered about. I guess they're small on a large ship. Hydro thrusters, and each side got an ore detector there. See, the front, this head, I'm not too keen on it. Yeah, I couldn't work out another way to do it. Maybe I'll sort it out eventually, but at the moment, I'm gonna have to deal with it already. Which might stupid some bottles left. Yeah, it kind of looks like a bit like Godzilla, I reckon. At least the head bit. But from the back, I really like it from the back. Even from the top down, it looks pretty cool. Yeah, so let's enter it. One thing I didn't think about when I was making this is a door to get into the ship. Sort of build it all. You'll notice the thrusters here aren't even either side. That is because pipework, there's basically a pipe here, but on this side it's a different angle of the pipe basically, which that may make more sense once we get in. And also the door here. I can't fit any more thrusters underneath it. Let's jump in. It is airtight. First, let's turn the lights on. So we've got med bay, oxygen tank, oxygen generator. I thought instead of trying to hide all the workings, I would try and show it. Try and show it off. We've got two ways we can go. This is going to either side of the ship. So we've got hydrogen thrusters. The reactors are off at the moment because we're running off the power from the base. Similar, I've had to put it in this way, so if need to, I can fit modulars here. And same this side really, identical. Apart from we've got some cargo containers here, and similar. We go upstairs again. If I can get upstairs, I don't trip. We've got some windows we can look out of. Nothing up here currently. It'd be good to put some chairs up here. This is a gravity generator? Yeah, a gravity generator. So yeah, that's the ship. Now it can hover with just the atmospheric thrusters, but from this height it struggles a little bit. I have to lift it a little bit. As we get further down to land, it does hover nicely. I think it's just because of the height that we are here. So what I would like to do is steal some uranium from the base. Unspell reactor, that is. Small. Okay, so we're gonna stick. How many can we stick? Let's take 300. And we're gonna evenly share that out. They should pull what they need, so in theory we shouldn't ever have a problem where one reactor fails. Due to not having enough, but just to be on the safe side, we will do it this way. And 25, right. We should have enough ice. Let's do this. Quite empty. Yeah, this is in the cargo container. We've got loads of ice. And I'm hoping we can take off while the sun's still kind of out, go into space, and try and find some uranium. Not uranium. Some. What's the component we need to make iron thrusters? Platinum. So let's turn my reactors on. This is my ore detector. I've been lucky enough to be able to grab some platinum from asteroids that have fallen down. Let me show you the colour difference. When everything's on, all the reactors. So what we're going to do is, we are going to lift off. First off, we're going to save it. We're going to lift off, we're going to go into space. We may need to stop for a little while once we're up there and let the hydrogen tanks refuel. And should I want to set up? Let's turn on these. And just make sure my tanks are full. Yep. And that they are set to stockpile and they're all off. Nice. Okay. Let's detach. We may drop a little bit, but we should have enough upward lift to lift back up. Oh, we didn't. Nice. Oh, nice. Pulled this in. We have no side thrusters. So we're going to need to turn those on just to get away from it. Oh, we need to turn this on. Whack them on. So just get away. Okay, then we whack them off. So it is able to float. Sometimes it doesn't. I'm not too sure what's going on. Okay, right, let's boost it. Begin our takeoff. Stop tilting it. I hope to get some screens up on the outside here with LCD displays showing my percentage of hydrogen, because at the moment obviously I have to go and do this. I'm going to switch over and we're going to turn them all on, but we're going to turn them off, bottom one's on, and then we're going to boost up. To 100, come off. Don't have a speed mod on, so we can only ever reach the speed of 100. And I do need to turn off my front dampeners. There we go, because they were slowing us down a bit. So we'll probably be left with about 20 or 30% hydrogen, I reckon, once we finish this. I'm just trying to keep it up to 100. Once we get further out of the gravity field, I can not press it as much. I can't remember if I shut the doors. Be a slight problem. If I didn't shut the doors, it would mean we'd lose an air. So I'll take my helmet off just to see. Seems to be alright. So we're gonna get tanks. Number 61, not bad, not bad. You may notice as well the top thrusters for downward are not in line. That's because if I had those two front ones a block back, the right one, it blows a hole in the side of the ship, and I think it gets too close to the refinery. So see an asteroid to our left there. And to our right. I was so happy before when I came across asteroids. What is that? Is that an asteroid? It's not a ship. Yeah, I was so happy because I had no idea what I was going to find when I came out here. And I was watching videos of people flying for hours in one direction and not seeing one asteroid. I was thinking all that work on that melting base and went to nothing, because I'd have to get rid of it. You know, there's no option to quickly change from asteroids in space on and off. It's a, well, now you have to create a new world. The moon is apparently a really good source for platinum. However, with no jump drive, it's 2 hours away. I'd imagine if you did have the option set up, you would have find a lot more asteroids. But this is survival, isn't it? So we'll do our best to survive. We'll see what we can make. Platinum is what we're after. So then I can change these sides to iron thrusters and the top as well for downward motion, and keep the bottom hydrogen thrusters and the back hydrogen thrusters for takeoff. Okay. Let's turn these off. Is it 5? Move in space. Let's check our hydrogen tanks, see what we got to. And they're automatically refilling, nice. So 37%. However, we do need to stop, so we're going to need to turn it back on. Try and slow us down. And we're going to set up the gravity generator and let it refuel some hydrogen, because we're still going to need to use the hydrogen to fly about a bit in space, but we may be able to stop just in time for that. Actually, that's what I may do. Work them off. Turn it. Aim for that. Maybe give it a nice thrust. Turn them off, let them regenerate. Maybe that. Gradually, slowly, coaster. So our hydrogen tanks look like. They're refueling, which is good. What about our ice? Ice is there. Did I take the ice? Oh no, I think I put the ice in the wrong container. No, I didn't. It's definitely one of those containers. Pick up anything? Iron, silicone. Let's get them to regenerate. Got our gravity boots on. I want to check is these. I'm sure I put the ice in one of these. Ah, here we go. I was panicking then. Ah, silicone. Give me the platinum. Apparently the moon has platinum, and apparently it is 2 hours away. So the next episode, hopefully we'll be landing on the moon, find some platinum, hopefully build a jump drive, attach it, place these with iron thrusters on the left and on the right and at the top, and then take as much platinum as we can back to the base, carry on finishing that. Until then, I'll see you in the next one.